Reality, what is this? A list of rules? A religion? I think not. Christianity is having a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. A relationship being something which encompasses both mind, body, and spirit. Well, why have this relationship? Well, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Alpha and the Omega, stepped down from his throne to take human form. True humility, I must say, the king becoming the peasant, the creator becoming the created. An eternal God became man as a baby. And why? Because he could not simply sweep our state of sin clean and carry on reign of perfect universe. The same way a judge cannot simply excuse a crime of rape, murder, or theft. Would this be fair? Therefore, Jesus Christ, the Son of God, took our consequence of sin on behalf of us, sinners, rather than giving us what we truly deserve. Death, he's given us a second, third, fourth, dare I say, even fifth chance to life, and all he wants in return is for us to be his friend. Jesus being a friend who makes himself vulnerable by exposing all his secrets in a book, the Bible, and all he wants us to do is to walk beside him in his mission of spreading love to all, mission of making disciples of all nations. But most importantly, he wants us to do everything for the glory of him who's given us this life. But many of you must be asking, you know, what's so special about his friendship? While Moses found the freedom nation and Joshua found led that same nation to the promised land, mighty men were thought of as servants. And understandably, the word servant strikes horror and disgust in the hearts of people today because of the justifiably negative connotation the term has earned over time. But with God, this term service is more deep and meaningful as it shows a deep commitment and an irrevocable relationship with the Father. So yes, Jesus doesn't use this word friend very lightly. So when he uses it in John 15:14, and I quote, "And you are my friends if you do what I command you to do," with his 11 disciples, it's a big deal because he's taking them into a more deeper, more meaningful relationship. And the greatest thing about this that us, the people who live in the age of grace, are desired to join them in this friendship. So we can become both servant and friend. The servant part just emphasizes on our desire to worship the Lord, and the relationship part just emphasizes on our friendship with the Lord. So we give ourselves to the Lord, putting our will down and his will above us, putting the cross before us and the world and all our guilt and shame behind us. So the affiliation with God is no longer religious. We no longer view him as some superior being out of reach, but as a friend, a true friend, the ultimate friend. But note that being his friend is becoming more than just a believer. Be blessed in Jesus' name.